many of the functions in data link allow you to be more selective than simply specifying time ranges for your data. In these examples, we use what we refer to as filter expressions, and filter expressions are found in functions like compressed data. They're found in functions such as sampled data, filter expression, and they're found in things like advanced calculated data with a filter expression. And the way the filter expressions work is they're an optional field to a query. Here's a query that I've done, compressed data, start time, end time, where I've simply got all the data for the last 8 hours from tag CDT158. And you'll notice that there are 89 values that are returned. I've also got a filter expression here that says CDT158 greater than 100. And what I'd like to do is find out over that period of time, not only the raw values, but the raw values where I meet that criteria. So what I'll do is go into my filter expression field and link to that cell and click OK. And you'll notice that over that period of time with that filter expression, I had 12. Now the nice thing about using a filter expression as a cell reference is that you can adjust your expressions very easily and come up with some different types of queries. I'll back this down to 80 and see how that changes it. You can see we've got 23 values now. So any of these fields you can use filter expressions. Of course you can either use the filter expression as a cell reference, or you can simply type the filter expression in. There's also something called Marcus filtered, which will show you the gaps. If you don't leave that checked, it won't show you where it filtered out data. And you can see here that I had quite a good run where I was over 80. And then it started filtering out again. It began its filter at 1020. That was the next value that got filtered. And I didn't have a new value until 1123. So you can choose whether to mark your filter points or not by using the mark as filtered checkbox.